Hello, this is Professor A.K. Pathak presenting this video, the part 2 of the partition, equivalence relation and rational numbers. In this video, we are going to talk about ordering in a partially ordered set and also bounds in a partially ordered set. The concept of ordering is very natural in our daily life. When you dress up, you put on your shoes and socks. But recall that the activity of putting on your socks precedes the activity of putting on your shoes. This is ordering. One activity precedes the other, or one element in a set precedes the other element. However, the ordering is not always attainable. It is attainable if we construct a certain mathematical structure on a given set. Let us proceed. Now there is a picture on your screen and you can see that there are four groups of some persons. Suppose we are asked to order these groups. The first question which arises in our mind is, what is the rule according to which we have to order? Because unless the rule is defined, unless we know the relation between the objects, you cannot order them. So it is always important to have a rule or relation when we are going to order a given set. Now see the first situation. The objects of the set are arranged when we consider the number of people present in the group. But if we consider the height of people present in the group, then we obtain the second type of ordering. Therefore, the nature of ordering is dependent on the rule which you adopt for creating that ordering. Now, you have a second picture on your screen. In this picture, you have a set X, the set containing the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we have a collection P of some subsets of X. In this collection, we have six subsets. Suppose we are asked to arrange in order the subsets being seen on the screen. Again, the question is how to order. Unless you have a sense of ordering or you have a relation or rule, you cannot order. So for ordering the subsets, you need a relation. And let us know what is that relation. You see that if we set a rule on the set P that a set A precedes set B if A is a subset of B, then you have this type of ordering. Naturally, you can see here that we are not able to order all the elements in a single chain. This situation is also a type of ordering. The earlier ordering and this ordering are having two different names. Now you can see that the first example gives you the idea of total ordering, whereas the second example gives you the idea of partial ordering. A partially ordered set is also called a poset. Let us move to have a mathematical formulation of these types of ordering. You can have the mathematical formulation of partial ordering and total ordering. Partial ordering means having a relation which has three properties. Reflexivity, that is, each element of the set is related to itself. Symbolically, we can write that A is related to A for all A in X. Antisymmetric, that is, if any two elements are mutually related, then they are equal. That is, if A is related to B and B is related to A, this implies that A is equal to B, and this happens for all AB in X. And the third is transitive. If one element is related to the second element and second element is related to a third element, then the first element is related to the third element. that is ARB and BRC, it implies that ARC. This is the way of writing these statements mathematically. One important note is, it is customary that a partial order relation R is denoted by the sign of less than or equal to. So whenever we write a partial order relation, we use this symbol, but it does not necessarily mean that using this symbol is anyway related to the general notion of less than or equal to. It may differ from that. Now, let us see whether the example which we have considered earlier is having a partial order relation. In that example, we have considered the relation of being a subset. Now, you can very easily see that X is always a subset of X for all X in this set P. And therefore, the relation is reflexive. Again, X is a subset of Y and Y is a subset of X. It implies that X becomes equal to Y. And therefore, the relation is antisymmetric. And lastly, if X is a subset of Y and Y is a subset of Z, then X becomes subset of Z. And therefore, the relation is transitive. And so, the relation which we have constructed on the set P is a partial order relation. Now, let us have another example. In this example, we have the set N of positive integers. And we consider the relation M less than or equal to N. It implies and implied by that M divides N, that is, M is a divisor of N. Now, for reflexivity, we see that M always divides M, and therefore the relation is reflexive. M is less than or equal to M. For antisymmetry, let us suppose that M is related to N and N is related to M, that is, M divides N and N divides M. Since M divides N, we can take M equal to NK, and since N divides M, we can take N equal to ML, where K and L are positive integers. Now, we can have M is equal to NK, but if we replace the value of N here, then we get M equal to MLK, and this implies M equal to M into LK, and it implies that LK is equal to 1. Since L and K are positive integers, it implies that L is equal to 1 and K equal to 1. And therefore, from here, you can now get that M becomes equal to N. So if we take that M is related to N and N is related to M, then we get that M is equal to N. It proves that the relation is antisymmetric. The transitivity is obvious. If M divides N and N divides P for M and P lying in the set N, then it is obvious that M divides P. And therefore, the relation is transitive. And so, the set N of positive integers endowed with this relation is a partially ordered set. Now, we introduce totally ordered set. Totally ordered set are also called chain or linearly ordered sets. They are basically partially ordered set in which given any pair of elements X and Y, you can say either X is less than or equal to Y or Y is less than or equal to X. That is, X precedes Y or Y precedes X. Equivalently, you can also say that any one of the statements, X less than Y or Y less than X or X is equal to Y, is correct. This is also called law of trichotomy. The set of real numbers with the natural ordering, that is, of less than or equal to, is a totally ordered set. Because you can very easily see that if you give you any two real numbers, say R1 and R2 in R, then it implies that R1 is less than R2 or R2 is less than R1 or R1 equal to R2, any one is at least true. So the R, that is the set of real numbers, is a totally ordered set, and due to that you can always have a line and arrange the real numbers in an ascending order, which you generally do. So R with the natural ordering is a totally ordered set. Now we are going to say that a partially ordered set may have some totally ordered subsets. In this example, which we have already seen, there are two totally ordered sets. One is this, and the second is this. This I have denoted by A, set containing the subsets 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and B is the set containing subsets 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So a partially ordered set may have some totally ordered subsets. Now we can see it in a more mathematical way. The set of positive integers with relation defined by m less than or equal to n implies and implied by m divides n is partially ordered but not totally ordered. For example, we have already seen that n is a poset. A poset means a partially ordered set. But you take any two sets, any two elements, 2 and 5, belonging to n, then 2 does not divide 5, also 5 does not divide 2. So 2 and 5 are not related, and therefore it is not totally ordered, because for being totally ordered, you know that this has to take place. For every pair, either x is less than equal to y or y is less than equal to x, that either x is related to y or y is related to x. But here we find that 2 and 5 are two elements in the set n which are not related to each other, and therefore this n cannot be totally ordered. But look for these subsets of n. The first subset, that is 2, 4, 16, it is very trivial to see that you take any two elements, take 4 and 16, then 4 divides 16. And similarly, you take any two elements, then one will divide the other. In this set also, you can very easily see that if you take any two elements, then one will divide the other. In this set also, if you take any two elements, then one will divide the other. And therefore, these all subsets are totally ordered. Subsets of N. So you can see that N is not totally ordered, but it has subsets which are totally ordered. Now we move to have some more concepts which you are already aware of, but in the sense of posets, we are going to again explain it. Now, what is a least element? Least element in a set X, if it exists at all, then it is an element which is less than or equal to all the elements present in the set X. Similarly, the greatest element of a set X is such an element which is greater than or equal to all the elements present in the set X, or you can say that all the elements in the set are less than or equal to the greatest element of the set. By the antisymmetry of the relation, because we are talking these things on a poset. So by the antisymmetry of the relation, it is clear that least or greatest elements, if exist, are always unique. For example, so say x and y are two list elements, then x is less than y if you consider x as the list element, and y is less than equal to x if you consider y as the list element. This gives you that x becomes equal to y. And therefore, if list element or the greatest element exists, then they are always unique. Now we come to a well-known concept, which is bounds on a Poset. In our earlier video, we have already talked about bounds on the real line. So we are not going to elaborate upon, but just having a passing mention. Let y be a non-empty subset of x. If there exists is very important. If there exists an element x in x such that y is less than or equal to x for all y in y, then x is called an upper bound of y and y is called as bounded above. And suppose y superstar is the set of all upper bounds of y and it has a least element y superstar, then y superstar is called the least upper bound of y. By analogy, you can also have the concept of lower bounds and greatest lower bounds. Now you can very easily see that since R is a partially ordered set, all these concepts apply on real line. Now we move to the next topic and we answer two questions. One is, can we apply the concept of bound in any set? And the second question is, can we have a bounded subset of the set of complex numbers? In fact, the concept of bound is applicable only when a set is ordered, partially or totally. You cannot apply the concept of bound on any set. The set has to be ordered, either partially or totally. For example, you have seen that R, with its natural ordering, is totally ordered. But if you apply the same less than or equal to on the set C of complex numbers, then it is not ordered because this less than equal to has no meaning in its natural sense. I'm again repeating, I'm using this in the sense of natural ordering on R. So if we take less than equal to like that, then C is not ordered and therefore you cannot talk of upper bound or lower bound in the set C of complex numbers. But if we define a relation like this, suppose C is the set of complex numbers and we take z equal to x1 plus iy1, w equal to x2 plus iy2, and we define z is less than equal to w, it implies and implied by x1 is less than equal to x2 and y1 is less than equal to y2. Then with this definition, you can very easily see that it is a partial order relation. It is a partial order relation on C. Very easily you can check it that if you take three elements, say 1 plus I, then 2 plus I3, then 5 plus I7, and if you take set of all these three elements, then this is the least element and this is the greatest element. But if you take two other elements, say 2 plus I3 and 1 plus I5, then these two elements are not comparable with the help of this relation. And therefore, you can very easily see that C is not totally ordered. With this relation, whenever we talk that it is partially ordered or totally ordered, that is always in reference to a particular relation. So if you change the relation, then the whole situation may change. So you can see that with the natural ordering of R, C is not ordered, but if we change the definition of ordering, then C becomes partially ordered, but again it is not totally ordered. And similarly, you can have some relations which can make C totally ordered, and you can frame it artificially. Now we move and see what is an order complete set. A Poset is said to be order complete if every non-empty subset which is bounded above has a least upper bound, or equivalently, a Poset is said to be order complete if every non-empty subset which is bounded below has a greatest lower bound. Now, one of the statements implies the other, vice versa. And therefore, if any one is true, the other you can always find. You can very easily see that R, which is a Poset, is having this property, and therefore R is order complete. Now we are moving to the last segment of our lecture, and we are going to introduce the idea of well ordering. Now what is well ordering? What is a well ordered set? A partially ordered set is called well ordered if every non-empty subset of X contains a least element. For example, you take the set N, then what is the least element? Least element, you know that N is partially ordered, and therefore what is the least element? Least element is 1, this is obvious, and therefore N is well ordered, and therefore N is can you say like this? N is well ordered because not only N, because if you take any element, any two elements, say 5 and 7, then it has a least element. This word every is very important. Every non-empty subset of X contains a least element. So every subset of N should contain a least element. That you can always see. If you have, in general, if you have N1, N2, NK, then the least element is N1. And therefore, you find that N is well ordered because N has a least element and all the subsets of N are also having a least element, and therefore N is well ordered. Now we have two propositions. One is any well ordered set is totally ordered, and the second is every subset of a well ordered set is well ordered with the same ordering. Now first, you can very easily see that let X be well ordered. Of course, X is a set, and we have to show that it is totally ordered. Now let XY belongs to X, then the set XY has a least element because the set is well ordered. And say X, and then x becomes less than equal to y. And so to you take any two elements, you have an ordering between them, and therefore this set x is totally odd. Now the second is very obvious, we are not going to prove it, that every subset of a well-ordered set is well-ordered with the same ordering. So the topic of discussion now comes to an end. If you like that such videos explaining the concepts of mathematics are useful for you, please subscribe to our channel and share the videos. Thank you. Thank you very much.